Blackstone Publishing presents Dispatches from Planet 3, 32 Brief Tales on the Solar System, the Milky Way, and Beyond, by Marcia Bartusiak. This book is read by Gabra Zackman. For Steve, My Pole Star. Preface. Almost no discovery in astronomy is a total surprise. Not really. Sifting through the histories of unexpected findings, one frequently encounters early hints, precursors, a sense of something in the air. As Isaac Newton famously noted in the 17th century, "If I have seen further, it is by standing upon the shoulders of giants." In other words, predecessors often pave the way, which makes the journey toward a new scientific vision possible. My mission over the past several years, when writing the essays contained in this book, was to provide the backstory for many recent astronomical discoveries. These explorations have included events in our nearby celestial neighborhood and out to the farthest reaches of the universe, even beyond space-time to the multiverse. I had no determined path in the course of my inquiries. Upon coming across a specific news item that piqued my interest, I headed to the archives to uncover a richer context. The controversial demotion of Pluto to dwarf planet, for example, reminded me when another solar system member was similarly downgraded in the 19th century. And the discovery of an amino acid within a stream of interstellar dust is only the latest confirmation of our intimate connection to the cosmos, knowledge that is surprisingly recent. For most of history, astronomers were not at all sure that the stuff of the heavens was the same as the stuff on Earth. And when news stories kept referring to Edwin Hubble as the discoverer of the expanding universe, I couldn't help but let readers know that a humble Belgian cleric, Georges Lemaître, and a former Midwest farm boy, Vesto Slipher, were equally responsible for revealing this astounding cosmic property. My armchair investigations whisked me off in spirit to exotic locales, to ancient Mars, when liquid water once flowed freely on its surface, to an ensemble of galaxies that to our eyes resembles Alice in Wonderland's Cheshire Cat, to the collision of two massive black holes a billion light years away, an event that released 50 times more energy than all the stars in the universe were radiating at that moment. And finally, down to the limit of the smallest quantum grain, where space and time allegedly come unglued and start to wink in and out of existence in a probabilistic froth. While assembling these articles into book form, I was pleasantly reminded I hadn't kept track of how many women I had portrayed over the years. I always let the news set my agenda, and lo and behold, there they were. Vera Rubin brings dark matter to the forefront of astronomical concerns. Jocelyn Bell keenly spots a bizarre new star. Henrietta Leavitt ingeniously devises a revolutionary cosmic yardstick. Jane Liu co-discovers the first solar system object beyond Neptune and Pluto. Beatrice Tinsley proves that galaxies evolve. Cecilia Payne tries to reveal the universe's major elemental ingredient until told to ignore it. And Margaret Burbidge contributes the observational proof that the calcium in our bones, the iron in our blood, and the oxygen we breathe came from the ashes of ancient stars. Many of these names are not found in astronomy textbooks, so it was gratifying to bring them into the spotlight. These are among the 32 stories in this collection, which I have loosely arranged, starting with our solar system and working outward in space-time to the Big Bang and beyond. There is no need, however, to read them in this particular order. For the most part, each chapter stands alone, so you are welcome to wander, as I have, along your own desired path among the stars. Dispatches from Planet 3. Chapter 1. Earth is but a speck. Our cosmic address keeps getting longer. Walk into an open field on a clear, moonless night. Overhead, sparkling stars are sprinkled across the sky. All of them seem equidistant from you and no one else. and you are lulled into imagining yourself at the center of the universe. For nearly 500 years, astronomers have struggled to break that illusion. Our petty standing in the cosmos is a scientific fact, if not a visceral experience. Earth zips at nearly 67,000 miles, 108,000 kilometers an hour around the sun, which in turn completes one lap around the Milky Way every 220 million.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.